Catherine's Chiselhampton, thank you very much for joining us. Like so many events this year, we have had to abandon our usual carols by candlelight service, which we have on the Friday before Christmas. But it's wonderful to be able to record this service in this beautiful church, and it's a joy to be able to share it with you. Many thanks to the Church's Conservation Trust for their hospitality to us. Thank you to Rachael for playing the organ, to Sharon for making the church look beautiful with some wonderful flower arrangements, to the choir for joining us, and to Stephen for a lot of work behind the scenes today and for a lot of work throughout the year looking after St Katherine's and keeping it looking so beautiful. Let us pray. I welcome you here on behalf of St Katherine's Chiselhampton. We have come together as the family of God in our Father's presence to celebrate the great festival of Christmas. In this service, we hear and receive the good news of the birth of Christ, and we offer to God our thanksgiving in the joyful singing of carols. We gather together in the name of Christ. We pray for the world he came to save, for the church that it may be enabled in our generation to surrender anew to God's holy wisdom, and to bear the good news of God's love to a needy world. For the world which is already Christ's, that all its peoples may recognise their responsibility for its future, and may be inspired by the message of Christmas to work together for the establishment of justice, freedom and peace everywhere. For all in special need, the sick, the anxious, the lonely, the fearful and the bereaved, that the peace and light of the Christ child may bring hope and healing to all who sit in darkness. We join our prayers together in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. First reading is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 2, 9, 6 to 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish it and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Thanks be to God.
He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom Of his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, How can this be, since I am a virgin? The angel said to her, The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child will be born, and be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God. Then Mary said, Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. She gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The fourth lesson is from Luke 2, verses 8 to 16. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with them the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favours." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. 2, verses 1 to 11. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men came from the east to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born, King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising, and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard of this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people, Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Bethlehem.
Hear our prayers.
We come before you, Christmas child, in silent amazement. May we welcome you among us, child of Bethlehem.
Hear our prayers.
As Mary welcomed you and rejoiced in God's holiness and mercy, we pray for the church as Christmas approaches. Child of Bethlehem,
hear our prayers.
As shepherds welcomed you, disturbing their work and their lives, we pray for your disturbing presence in our world. Child of Bethlehem,
hear our prayers.
As Joseph welcomed you, giving you a home and a name, we pray for all who seek shelter in our community today. Child of Bethlehem,
hear our prayers.
As angels welcomed you, singing of glory and peace, we pray for all who seek healing and hope. Child of Bethlehem,
hear our prayers.
As wise men welcomed you, risking a journey and following a star, we pray that we may take risks in following you. Child of Bethlehem,
hear our prayers.
The love of God is in us. The spirit of joy is with us. Emmanuel, Jesus, God with us, now and always. Amen.
Amen.
We stand now for the reading from John's Gospel, the first chapter, beginning in the first verse, continuing to the 14th verse. St. John unfolds the mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life. And the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light, the true light, which enlightens everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas time. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you and all who you love and care for, now and always. Amen.
On the second day.